tribe to take on the Bobcats. And the latest Rourke to start at quarterback, it's Curtis Rourke. Nathan's younger brother is now the man leading OU at QB. From Peden Stadium in Athens, Ohio, it's Maction on a Tuesday night. Both the Zips and Bobcats in the search of their first win of this abbreviated six-game 2020 turn against the Chips. Now, Akron has struggled. They've lost 18 games in a row going back to 2018, but we love the swagger of their young redshirt freshman quarterback, Zach Gibson. A nice Zoom call with him this week. He's ready to go, right?
Oh, he is, and you could tell that he believes in his team. He believes in his offensive line, believes in his wide receivers. He thinks they're going to have success, and the coaches believe in him, too.
A beautiful night for college football here in Southeast Ohio. It is just perfect, 71 degrees as the cannon is fired. Very few chances of rain here tonight. Ohio leads the all-time series. They've met every year since 92. Last year it was a big Bobcat win in Akron against the Zips, 52-3. Peden Stadium, oldest in the MAC, built in 1929. Sits 27,000 friends, family, spirit squad, and band. Approximately 1,500 allowed here tonight. Face masks and social distancing is required. Ohio's won the toss, electing to receive. To begin our game here tonight at Peden Stadium, Tom Arth, year two, will try to get his first career victory as an FBS head coach. Tuggle, deep to receive the kick. Directional. They want to keep it away from Tuggle. And it's taken outside the 35-yard line. 12-yard return. So here is Curtis Rourke, a redshirt freshman quarterback. Oakville, Ontario. Brother Nathan started 37 straight games here in Athens and was one of the all-time greats in Ohio history. But now it's Curtis's turn to take over. And yes, he's got a chip on his shoulder, trying to deal with being the younger brother. On first down, Amatre Tuggle gets out to the 40-yard line, picks up two.
Well, one of the big players, I think, to watch for this Ohio offense is Isaiah Cox, number six. And also, you got Hagan Maservi, number 76, starting for the first time this year at right tackle. And that's a big change for them because he's been one of their stalwarts, I think, inside at the right guard position. Thought he struggled a little bit against Akron in the last game of last season. It was just okay a week ago. Very good player.
On second down, Tuggle again tries the middle. And he's ripped backwards. Ryan McClain had his first career start against Western Michigan last week, and that home loss for Akron makes the play.
And this defensive line is going to be the key for them tonight. They've got a lot of guys that are really depending on it, and one of those guys is McClain. You see right there, number 94, John Mitchell. He's also going to be a big factor. And here's the third down. This is where Akron has to get better in 2020, and this is a big test.
Clap snap, Curtis Rourke. Throws for the first time. Brooks has the catch, sticks route, has the first down. And he's dropped it about midfield. On a good pickup of 7 yards. Chain mover for the Bobcats. Jordan Riley on the play defensively.
Well, I like what they did. Watch him come at and bring some pressure. Good blitz pickup that time by Demontre Tuggle. It's one of the things that he's been challenged by to get better in that facet of his game, and I think he's improved there.
Touchdown for Hooks against Central Michigan last week. They call him Hollywood. He's got the glitz. He's got the game. Got the good nickname, right? Rourke takes a shot to Hollywood. Who's got it? Shane Hooks. The big time play. Big pickup Bobcats to the 10-yard line of Akron. Pick up a 40, first and goal.
We knew we were going to get some of these one-on-one shots down the field. They vacate the post.
Tuggle tries to keep things going. He'll pick up about a yard on first and goal. 79 yards and a touchdown for Tuggle in the opener. The touchdown and the kickoff return for a score we told you about. So the post and the successful throw to Hooks. Last week in the loss in Mount Pleasant, Isaiah Cox on the deep route brought one in from Curtis Rourke. Double feature back again. Got second to go. Demontre Tuggle makes his move. Sprints into the end zone. Touchdown, Ohio. What a start for the Bobcats tonight.
Take a look inside. Nazir's side, number 11. They do a really good job of finishing him off. And Kurt Danica returning to the lineup. He makes an excellent block as well. The offensive line making an imprint early.
Tristan Vandenberg, one of the two new kickers here in Athens, has a PAT. Hollywood. Hooks with a big catch, and then the touchdown chain. What a start here for the home team.
No doubt, man. Right now, if you're a Bobcat, you're feeling it.
Demontre Tuggle, star offensive players for Ohio, and Chave, that was quick. Six plays, 62 yards, and Hooks was the man.
Well, there's no surprise. I mean, they had seven explosive plays a week ago, but for Akron, Boogie and Dollar. We're talking about Boogie Knight, Teon Dollar. Those running backs have to keep the momentum going from a week ago. And then take defensive gambles. You already saw them pressure on one third down. For Ohio, create a light box. That means spread out this Akron defense and run the ball. They did that on the first drive. And speed up Akron's offensive line. A lot of stunts, line games from Ohio's defensive line against their offensive line tonight.
Tristan Vandenberg. Missed a field goal attempt, 45-yarder last week in Mount Pleasant. Will kick to Boogie Knight. Jeremiah Knight, Ohio State transfer, a former slot receiver.
And he had a really big game last year against Ohio returning the ball, Dave. He averaged 28 yards a kickoff return in that last game of the season. So they know all about him in this return game.
Here's Boogie. He'll take it out. From his goal line, Jeremiah Knight looks for a seam and is dropped outside the 20. And that's where Akron takes over for the first time tonight with Zach Gibson. Did have a pick six first quarter in the loss to Western last week. Redshirt freshman, Alpharetta, Georgia. A touchdown pass and a couple good drives to Mike Matheson, not available tonight. So they did have some. Keeps on trucking. Key Thompson finally wrestles him down. That wasn't easy. He went backwards a couple yards. First down, Akron.
Yeah, this guy's impressive. Now, we talked about it in the beginning, these running backs. And what don't forget, a year ago, it's 1.8 yards a carry. They're going over here to the right side. Look at the block by Maverick Wolfley. An outstanding block. Then he makes the spin move against Jamison Collier, who the coaches felt, particularly their defensive coordinator Ron Collins, was their best tackler in the secondary.
Don't you love this hearing of Wolfley? In the game again. Dollar on the first down carry after picking up 15, gets two more yards out to the 40 as we check the starters.
And one player that really is defensive ends for Ohio.
He's a big man, Chave. He's a big dude. 6'9", 300, redshirt freshman. Second down. Teon Dollar around Dorsa, trying to hang on and keeps on breaking tackles. Finally, Jaron Hampton makes the play, but not before Teon Dollar himself will say. First down, zips.
Yeah.
Powerful north-south running, and the chains move again.
And watch it bounce right here. And now you've got the one-on-one tackle against Dorsa. Gets him the stiff arm. He can't grab.
Transfer And a great start for Akron offensively. What a relief that must be just to be in positive territory. Followed this time out on a pass row. No game there for Akron. On the run from Jeremiah Knight. How difficult is it, Jay, moving from a slot receiver spot to a running back in the same season?
It's pretty difficult because of the pounding, Dave. But you're now having to blitz pickup. A 230-pound linebacker comes in. You got to face him up. The good thing for them, though, with him in terms of Knight, and as a matter of fact, you'll see Knight actually out wide right here to the bottom of the screen, is his versatility. He makes them decide who you're going to cover him with, giving Akron the advantage.
So Ohio's starting lineup defensively. Second and 10 here. Empty backfield. Next to Gibson. Redshirt freshman faces some heat. And that pass incomplete.
And Dave, you really brought up a good point right there. You talked about Knight moving from receiver to running back. Well, guess what? Dorsa had to go out. And sometimes coaches just want to get a feel for who's going to cover Knight out of the backfield. That's a mismatch for Akron that they'll have to go back to later because they got Dorsa, the Mike linebacker, to go out and have to cover him at receiver.
Pass intended there for the redshirt freshman from Brecksville, Ohio, Sean Mame. So a lot of redshirt freshmen, a lot of young guys, transfers as Akron tries to fill a lot of holes and rebuild. 18-game losing streak. Been a long time since they were victorious in Northeast Ohio. Boogie Knight drives the pile forward. He's inside the 35 to the 34-yard line, but shy by about five.
Well, that was third down and 10. Interesting call from Brian Gasser. He decides to run the ball because he knows that Ohio was gearing up to pressure because they also knew they were going to go for it here on fourth down. Now what do you go to? Anticipating man, I expect some bunch sets, stack looks, something to kind of get that man coverage off the receiver.
Love the optimism in our Zoom call with Tom Arth yesterday. Second-year head coach trying to rebuild everything, academics, socially, the culture at Akron. One for two, fourth down tries last week, home loss to Western. They'll try here on a fourth down play. And it's blown up. The second effort, not enough either. Jet Elag comes in to make the big play on Tony Grimes Jr. No gain, and on downs, Ohio's going to get it back.
Yeah, when you come up and you make
time
a tackle like this,
media.
It's about a statement. It's about, I'm a defensive back. I'm going to get my man on the ground.
our virtual fans and the COVID era. But it comes up empty, turning over on downs. And back to Curtis Rourke in the offense for Ohio. Option look. Cox. Isaiah Cox. Has got wheels. Arslanian can't bring him down. Makes a cut, picks up more real estate. Julian Richardson, finally the outside linebacker, with a put-down tackle for Akron. And again, Ohio in business.
Well, he's a former high school running back, and he's their return guy. And so when you get caught up inside, as the corner Jordan Riley does on that play, Arslanian has to come and make the play in pursuit.
Gain of 28. Curtis Rourke taking over for his brother. Slinging it. Odom has the catch. Cam Odom, team captain, two-year captain here, and very impressive in the movement at Ohio with the student athletes. Fighting social injustice. Got, as we see the catch chain, all of the football team and several other sports teams, men's and women's, 100% to vote this year on Election Day last week. Amazing effort by Cam Odom.
Yeah, and I think the coaches were really impressed with just how he's been able to balance the two, because he's gotten better. You can see at the receiver position doing all of those things you referenced.
3-9. Toggle time again. Flag flies as Lanigan has the tackle. The undersized yet star linebacker for Akron. We'll check out our call.
Holding. Offense number 61. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Second down.
There's Tim O'Day. Also a mechanical engineer. That's impressive. From Nebraska. He's our referee tonight.
Well, here we got it inside. You can see the grab inside against really a player that's really getting his first big action, Logan Hawkins.
After the holding call, second down long. Catch first time this year for Alec Burton, the sophomore from Danville, Indiana. Player came up on our Zoom call yesterday about the third tight end. We got Ryan Lorman and Adam Lorman, the twins, and getting some more snaps and clearly targets is Alex Burton.
That's exactly, David. And he's one of the guys that when me and you came here a year ago, me and you were talking about him and during practice, well, just how impressive he looked. Former Mr. Football in the state of Indiana. He's a very good overall, really just third tight end. He's really more like a starter.
Dionisio, tackle for Akron. Third down here, short field for Ohio. See what Tim Albin, offensive coordinator, has in mind. Blitz on the outside from Arslani. Rourke swallowed up, down it goes. Who got to him? Bubba Arslanian. All of 5'9", 205, and I think that's stretching it. And we had a great chat with Bubba this week. Former All-State High School wrestler uses his leverage to get guys to the ground, right?
He does, and you watch it. It's all out blitz. We talked about Gamble. Tuggle doesn't know who to pick up, and he comes back, and you think Ohio's on the field after that, and we got to give defensive coordinator Matt Feeney some credit. He was like, listen, we're going to come after it when we have our shots. He's gone and done that a couple times already, and what a job by this Akron defense to get off the field.
Jack Wilson, new punter for Ohio. Runner Louis Zervos and Michael Farkas. Jeremiah Knight wants the fair catch and makes it just outside the 10. In the 11-yard line for Akron. Confidence-building defensive stop for the Zips.
Timeout
against
the
Ohio's
needed.
Powerful offense. Akron back on the field with Zach Gibson, the redshirt freshman quarterback, once again when we return. Loves coaching and teaching. He says, when the kids stop listening to me, then I'll stop coaching. But right now, I'm having a blast. 113 wins he'd like to catch Don P. And that'll be next year, though, with the abbreviated schedule in 2020. Offense back on the field for Akron. Dollard really ran hard in that first drive. Gain of about a yard. Always a pleasure, Chave, to speak with Frank Solich, who accomplished such great things at Nebraska and has become a true legend in the MAC.
He really has. And really, I think the thing that has made him so consistent has been the fact that he's been able to replace the quarterback position a number of different times. And now he gets Nathan Rourke's little brother, Curtis, to fall right into his laps. And we haven't even gotten into Armani Rogers, the other quarterback from the Mountain West.
UNLV transfer, should see him tonight. Gibson throwing, that ball tipped and incomplete. Hudson with a breakup and nearly intercepted.
That was a really good break by Jamison Collier too. He kind of baited Gibson. And one of the things that I thought Gibson kind of struggled a little bit in their game against Ohio at the end of last season was taking defenders to the ball. It's a really good break by Collier. He has to be careful with his eyes in this game.
39.
Now, do they bring pressure? I think that's the big key on this down.
Only four third down conversions last week in the loss to Western. That pass complete. Rhymes Jr. makes the catch and lunges ahead for the first down for Akron.
That's a strong throw from Gibson. Now he's going to stand in here. This is similar to last year when they were running some of these line games, but he makes an excellent throw right in front of Ohio's one of their younger players, Elad, that you had talked about earlier, yeah, making a big play.
Quite a hit by Jay Elad. End of that play.
38-7.
Chain mover for Akron. Fragile type team, winless so long. Watching Gibson slide. He's safe at second. Flag flies late. Let's check out the marker. With that perfect QB slide to avoid contact. Would have got a first down, but let's check out the call and see what our officiating crew has in mind here at Peden Stadium.
Holding, offense number 66. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
4-5. Starting offensive lineman change for Tom Arthur, a redshirt freshman. And that's Ryan Beckman out of Avon Lake, Ohio. Guilty party.
Here he goes inside, and he's working against Matthews. And right here, you got to be able to let go. Gets outside the, when you get outside the shoulder pads, and that's a clear indicator. A lot of times, you get away with those holds if you keep the hands inside of the shoulder pads, but unable to do it. And he didn't move his feet, which was something that when you watched him a week ago also showed up.
Devastating penalty. Pass brought in. Getting back to about the original line of scrimmage. Catch for Nate Stewart, team captain, redshirt senior, Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Been productive. Coaches like Brian Gasser telling us yesterday, very good leader. 37 catches a year ago. Someone's got to step up, Corey. Yeah, well, Akron team this year.
I think you saw some guys step up already. I mean, Teon Dollard has gotten off to a good start.
Sure.
Boogie Knight has been an all-purpose player for a couple years now. And Nate Stewart had a pretty good season a year ago. So those guys had to have more production.
Dollard running hard again. Jamal Hudson, contact Jamison Collier. He had 8 tackles against Central last week with a hard hit.
You know what, Dave? I thought you brought up something. You said somebody has to step up. I think that's what the coaches are trying to get out of the mind of.
Gibson loves to stay on the field. Here comes some pressure from Dorsa. Gibson, elusive. Slides ahead. That's hit hard by a couple of Bobcats and is short. A yard a game.
So you go for it here on fourth down.
No.
I think that's the question.
I don't think you do.
You see this pressure coming out there. It's Eli Dorsey. He just beats the sack potentially of Dorsa. And Matthews retracts his steps. Collier comes up. Good run by Gibson. And deciding to go ahead and give Romanek a chance to punt this one away.
Isaiah Cox, game for the Bobcats.
Here's some punts. And Cox, deep man to receive. For the Bobcats, at his 15. You know he's elusive. 2 flags are down. The 38 and the 41. So let's check out the markers.
They had a week ago, but then that drive, you got something going
during the return. Holding
your game, Mackey Showdown tonight on CBS Sports Network.
Throughout second week in a row, he's completed one of those, and then he's throwing the ball outside the numbers with the velocity and pace that you need.
First 2 possessions, numbers so far for Curtis. After Nathan's record-setting career, Nathan's waiting up in Canada, hoping for a shot at the CFL.
Well, I think for Tuggle, the big thing is now you're running behind Nick Singh.
To Tuggle on the check down. Arslanian can't make the play. bump out of bounds there by Brandon Bischoff, inside linebacker for Akron. Get it to.
Well, he's a walk-on, and it's going to be a big. He breaks him off, but then Bischoff is going to have to play big tonight. He's coming into the lineup, and they need. Hit by 2-2 Derenijo.
He's a good one.
Yeah.
End of the quarter, Chave. 15 in the books. Zach Gibson, we told you about the attitude. He's pumped up tonight. Playing. Well, 7-0. Bob.
Our golfer, Annika Sorenstam. Give an update on the upcoming Masters. And also, Amanda Baliona sits down with Hall of Famer Nick Faldo and his female caddy, Fanny Sunnison. We'll talk about her groundbreaking career. Catch it all right here on CBS Sports Network. First quarter numbers, Jade, to take a look at.
And the balance for Ohio is commendable. I mean, nearly identical pass and rush yards. And that's something that's got to flip a little bit. But Akron, the rush yards, got to be impressed with that.
Big third down. And four here for the Bobcats to begin the second. Tuggle, long scoring run so far. Boy handoff carries here. Looks for room. Bischoff got there first. Brandon Bischoff pumping his fist because Tuggle stopped a yard and a half shy. Ohio's got a punt.
That's a very.
Hampton, the recovery for Ohio. And on a short field, Ohio's got great field position coming up. Here's the play, Chave.
And it just really, he fumbles it off of the offensive lineman's. A leg. I mean, it hits off of the leg, and when you're not used to running in between the tackles, sometimes that happens. Here goes Armani Rogers getting a shot with him.
We thought we might see him in this situation beginning the second quarter. Frank Solis told us yesterday he would be probably starting the second quarter for Ohio. And carries on first down. He's so dangerous. Running quarterback, the former Mountain West freshman of the year, Armani Rogers, a smooth operator, long strides, and what a runner he is.
And I got a story, I have a little bit of a story to tell about how much you were intrigued as him at UNLV. Because before the game, you were talking about this guy for at least 20 minutes because you hadn't seen a quarterback that big.
Yeah, he was something. Saw him a couple years ago in a game with the Air Force when he was at UNLV. Then research picked the program he thought he fit best with, and here he is. Grad transfer from the Mountain West. First and goal for the Bobcats, gain of 24.
They're going to speed up the base. You got to be alert for the zone read here now. Him keeping it, and they're going to take a look at this and verify that catch.
Ruling on the field on the previous play of completion is under review.
Let's see if he got. The feet, I think, are down. It's about maintaining control through the ground, and I see the ball come up a little bit when he hits the ground, and I don't know if this is going to stand. Let's take another look at it.
Possession of the ground.
From those angles, they were good angles, but you tell me what you think from this angle. Dave.
It's a tremendous play by Isaiah Cox.
Does the ball move when it hits the ground?
The foot was established. Now, the foot was actually to the paint when he caught the football. So my question is the foot out of bounds when he actually makes contact?
Yes.
Because he establishes the feet first.
Yeah, I didn't have much of an issue with the feet.
Okay.
I think right here he's in with the feet.
He's got the ball, yeah.
I mean,
great look
see,
there.
You can see the
great look there.
That's a better look at it. You can see the feet are in.
I'm going to say good catch.
It's about controlling it through this contact with the ground. I think that's the part.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field of completed catch is confirmed. Number 6 had firm possession, right foot down in bounds.
All right.
First down.
First and goal for the Bobcats. What a play by Cox.
And now Rodgers in this part of the field. I really thought he got their running game going a little bit last Wednesday. And one of the reasons is you got to account for him.
Tonight's Red Zone being brought to you by Verizon. First and goal, you're right, extra running back. And very tough to tackle Armani Rodgers. Sean Allison, feature back here. Claps that. First and goal.
This is the one
Rodgers
that pushed through our area early.
First touchdown to Bobcat. He's in. Touchdown, Ohio. Armani Rodgers.
Really get along great. Him and Curtis Rourke. And I tell you what, that's pretty interesting because both of them probably feel like they should be starting.
Vandenberg is in for the PAT. Knocks it through the upright. And it's 14-0 Ohio. It was the fumble first.
Came down to talk about Lowe actually making a key pass at the end.
On the bounce, Knight, who fumbled a few moments ago for Akron, fields it from the 10. Runs into a wall of green, shy of the 20. They're going to get to the 20-yard line for forward progress on the kickoff return from Tristan Vandenberg. And Akron's got it right back here. 59 straight points for Ohio, scored head-to-head with the Zips. If you go back to last year, 45 in a row last year in the 52-3 win at InfoCision Stadium in Northeast Ohio. And the Bobcats up by a couple scores here. Thanks to the Rodgers run after that tremendous play by Cox. Let's see how the young QB out of Georgia, Zach Gibson, redshirt freshman, responds this time. Feature back is Teon Dollar. In motion, whistles first and flags. Delay of game.
Yeah.
So not a good response.
Delay game, offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Yeah, that to me is kind of unexcusable. I'm sorry. You're coming back after a kickoff.
Please reset the game clock.
You got to have that
12:20.
You got to have that operation basically like clockwork. You already know what play it is you're going to go to, and to have a delay a game to waste 5 yards down 14. That's how your team starts to lose confidence.
Big theme with Akron. And talking with Tom Arth was trying to stay neutral. Don't look at the scoreboard. Look at the play ahead of you. Dollard on the first and 15, stopped by Dorsa. Gets a couple of yards. Give him two on the run for Akron. So it's 18 in a row. Kansas, New Mexico, ODU. And the Monarchs are not playing this year in Conference USA, one of the teams that is opting out of fall football in 2020. Been a while. October 27th against the Chips, 2018. But you would not know it from speaking with Tom Arth, his coordinators and players like we did via Zoom this week. Talk about a positive outlook to try to rebuild the program at Akron. Gibson, flushed, hit as he throws. Nice adjustment there for George Qualls, but it's ruled incomplete. As he tries to grab that fluttering pass, throw down a long.
Now I thought George Qualls would be a guy that they would want to get involved in the game at some point. And here we go. You see the pressure. Really, McCracken is somebody that's come on, the sophomore for Ohio. And this is a situation you don't want to be in. Now, the screen game is a possibility on these third and long situations. They run a lot of those screens to Knight, but here's Dollard in the backfield.
Back wants a timeout, and Zach Gibson is furious with somebody.
Akron called their first charge timeout of the half. This will also be a media timeout.
We'll take a quick timeout, too, here in Athens, Ohio. Two-score game. Matching on a Tuesday night on CBS Sports Network.
Dear Max, dear Abigail, Harper, and Hudson, I know I'm not supposed to choose favorites, but you're my number one. Sent you a little something special. Happy holidays. Love, Grandma.
Harper, Hudson, let's open your presents from Grandma.
Come here, Max. Here you go.
Abigail.
Guys, say cheese. Come on.
get the gift we sent you, Mom?
We did. We loved it.
You should do this every year.
Give the perfect gifts this holiday from Chewy.
Third and 13 coming up here for Akron off the timeout. What do you think Zach Gibson was so upset about there?
Well, I think, again, we're talking about operation. We've had a delay of game to start to drive off, and now all of a sudden it's third and 13. You got to know where to line up. And so those types of plays can get frustrating for a quarterback who wants to have some success.
Sean Name in motion. Zips really need this one. One play. Teon Dollard looks for the edge. Conrad first to get to him. He won't find the edge. It's back to about the original line of scrimmage. Give him three, and it's punt time again for Akron.
And Conrad is just an energetic player, but right here, this is about more than just energy. This is about being able to get off the block of Owen Murphy, number 73. And anytime you're running an outside run, you have to try to reach the outside shoulder of that defensive end. Couldn't get it done against Conrad, probably their emotional leader on defense.
Kyle Romanekin, redshirt freshman, Fort Mill, South Carolina. That's outside Charlotte, North Carolina. Bobcat showing some pressure. Good kick, Cox. Gonna grab it at about the 41. Watch out, got the wheels. As Laney has got him, though. That's Bubba, right? On punt coverage. Wow, what a tackle. And, you know, you speak with the Akron coaches, and Matt Feeney, defensive coordinator, said, boy, he is a thumper. He's not a big dude, but can he ever make contact with the opposition? And that is a perfect form tackle by Bubba Arslanian.
And watch how he oh, man. I mean, that just first foot
that's
through.
That's wrestling position.
Stepping right through. And that you won't find a better tackle this season than the one you just saw from Bubba Arslanian. And that's why he's a player that, you know, really the coach Ars called him, the head coach, the heart and soul of our defense. Yeah. Maybe the heart and soul of the whole team.
He's a captain. Well, Mac preseason pick. Rodgers stays on the field. And passing to Jerome Buckner, who's back in the Ohio lineup. Pick up to about the 45-yard line. Buckner has overcome a couple surgeries. They weren't sure if he'd be in the lineup tonight. In our discussions with coaches yesterday, sophomore from Columbus.
Yeah, Gahanna Lincoln High School there, 100 meter, 200 meter fastest guy. We talked to the strength coaches on the team, 4.38 speed. So always got to keep an eye on him when he's in the game because this team likes to take vertical shots. It's a run first team that hits the big shots down the field.
Rodgers only 1 for 3 in his action last Wednesday, 6 days ago in Mount Pleasant, lost by 3 points to Central Michigan. Mesh play, O'Shawn Allison runs into trouble. 2-2, Darinijo, sophomore from Fort Lauderdale, first one to arrive with some mean intent.
Matt Feeney, their defensive coordinator, loves this kid and just, you know, just talking about how he triggers. And he's one of those guys that, you know, he really does. They look for guys that have those high GPAs sometimes. Wasn't mm-hmm. a really highly recruited kid.
It's quite a story about him, yeah.
Yeah, and that GPA, you know, Dave, he's like you. He's a business data analytics major. So
that was not my major at Syracuse by a long shot.
Oh, man. Well, I know you keep your business in order.
I try. Third down on a short field. Could be four down territory for the Bobcats here. Here's Rodgers facing some pressure. Flushed. Arslanian going to get there. Bubba makes the play on the big guy, Armani Rodgers. How about Bubba Arslanian? Redshirt Junior Aurora, Ohio. The former state wrestling champ team captain gets it done for Tom Arth. Loss of 6.
He's something else. And well, he can get low to the ground. I mean, he's already built low to the ground. And then that allows you to get away from the stiff arm by the much, much bigger Rodgers.
Wow. Wilson from Australia, rugby-style kicker. Bogey Knight watches that one bounce, and look at the kick coverage. Well done by Ohio.
Yeah, Tariq Drake.
And Tariq Drake was there, right back up, strong safety. You see a lot of him defensively as well. 46-yard punt by the Aussie, Jack Wilson. Lancefield, Victoria, Australia gets it done. Harvard on the Hocking, right next to the Hocking River here in
guess you didn't.
Beautiful
run.
Part of the state. I went for a hike the last 2 days.
Okay.
We'll talk about that too. Movement up front. Hang on. Lots of movement. There's a flag and a whistle. As Akron starts to drive deep in its own end here.
And Bryce Dugan's been getting some playing time inside a little bit. Number 52. Defensive end.
Offside. Defense number 52 was in the neutral zone, causing the offense to react. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Right on cue, that's Dugan. The redshirt sophomore, Milford, Ohio, and it gives Tom Arthon the Zips some breathing room. That's a big break.
Yeah, much needed breathing room. You can see the reaction. Look at Xavier Gray, the 6'9 tackle. He's like, right here.
He did it.
We, if you're pointing him out, we can see it.
6'9, 300 pounds. Wow. That's impressive. It's fun watching him warm up tonight.
Yeah.
Play fake for Gibson. Gonna throw, take a shot on the sideline route, brought in George Qualls. Corey Chavis said he had to come up big tonight. Corey Chavis watched him in warm-ups tonight, was so impressive with Qualls.
Oh, man.
And on the go route, he makes a grab.
I mean, this is the guy, if you want to find maybe a program changer. Butler Community College, one of the best junior colleges in the country. They were seventh in the nation last year. He made catches like this consistently. Look at him, over the top of Jamal Hudson, he had over 600 yards, almost 700 yards, and 6 touchdowns. If you play good football at Butler Community College, Dave, then I got a lot of respect for you. That's like playing major college SEC football, big-time football, and he's a guy they got to get the ball to.
Gain of 35, only had one catch for 14 yards last week. Pressure coming, and Gibson flushed, broken up. Looking there for Maverick Wolfley.
Look at Vonnie Watkins.
And the play by Watkins moving pretty well. Vonnie Watkins, the sophomore from Lusby, Maryland.
We talked with the coaches about him as well, and Ryan Collins said he's getting better with reps. Well, that was a great repetition there, or at least a good one. The range, I like this movement when I watched him. He's an interesting prospect.
What are your questions to the coaches? Ron Collins, defensive coordinator for Ohio, on our Zoom yesterday. Used to be conference calls. Now it's all Zoom calls.
You like the Zoom better.
I do like it to see the expressions. I mean, I miss, of course, speaking with players and coaches in person. It's a different world in 2020. But we're grateful to have that time. Gibson throwing. Deion Dollard is tracked down by Dorsa. A nice pickup for Akron again.
I don't think you like me on the Zoom. but hey, listen, we talked about these running backs, Dave, and getting them involved against Dorsa. Me and you talked about this all week. Did you see the matchup there? Dollard against Dorsa. So if you can get Dorsa one-on-one, we'll see what happens.
Gain of 9, 31, big play here. Got to imagine four down territory. Hey, you're down 2 scores. You've lost 18 straight games. You got to go for it, right?
Well, the pace of the game, because they ran it early, there's only 7 minutes left in the half. You get a first down now, you're shortening the game.
Deion Dollard. Little shake and bake move. That spot looked short, though. He didn't get there.
Not at all.
He did not get there. Rodney Matthews, among many Bobcats to get to him. Now fourth down for Tom Arth, the young head coach, year 2, after coming from Chattanooga at the FCS level. Big fourth down play. That's woefully in motion. Got 2 timeouts. Zips need this one, let's face it. Timeout. With 5 on the play clock.
Charge timeout, Akron. Their second of the half.
Good timeout, what do you think?
Yeah, I think so. At this point, you've got to try to find your best play. And one of the things that can work for them is the screen. But do you believe your offensive line is better than their defensive line, or is as good? Probably not, based on last year's matchup. They're improving, and got a couple of nice young players that we like a little bit. But inside, you feel like you're just going to be able to run it inside? Based on the game thus far, though, Dave, they've actually had success. You've got to find out right now whether your offensive line is ready to win a football game in the MAC. I believe you challenge your team and run this football. And don't try to get, overly cute or anything. It looks like they're actually bringing another quarterback in the game.
My Jaden Horton is a player we've got listed here. We did a wild zip look on the biggest play of the game. Direct snap. Dorsal the tackle. That spot looks pretty good for a first down for Akron. How about it? Horton comes in. The wild zip look. Gibson returns. First down, Tom Arth picks up two.
I like the call. I think you got to challenge your team at some point, and here it goes. And we're going to challenge you, Xavier Gray. If you watch the left side of that line, they knocked a couple of guys down, and now we're getting a, looks like a Akron play.
Being attended to by Bobcat trainers in the injury tent currently. Try to keep you updated. So first down, Gibson back in the field. Look, two-score game here. All of a sudden, a touchdown, one-score game. Kind of where they were at the end of the first half last week against Western. Gibson running. Conrad to stop. But a positive north-south run for the freshman, Zach Gibson. He's also a big fan of Aaron Rodgers, of course. Big Ben.
Right.
He's got a, you know, a couple of those traits when you watch him play on tape and in person. But I love his attitude. That, to me, was the most impressive thing.
Yeah, it really was. And I think the coaches believe that he can make most of the throws. And they said, you know what, he believes he can make every
That's
throw.
Right. We asked him his favorite throw. He said the dig. Coaches said he'll do anything. He likes them all.
You see him right here. He's actually calling out the cornerback potential pressure off the edge. So he shows he's got the mind, too.
Second down. Pressure from Dorsa. The captain for Ohio throws in the move. And Grimes Jr. has the catch. What a play. I'm not sure if the ball was intended for him, but Tony Grimes has the
catch. But that's about believing your eyes. His older brother, Tyler.
Jeremiah Knight indicates for it, makes the fair catch outside the 22-yard line. That's where the Zips take over first and 10. You know, we had in our Zoom chat yesterday with Frank Solich, the legendary head coach for Ohio. As we take a look here, sorry, Chad, go ahead.
Well, here he goes right here. Let's watch what he does. And really, when you see him come inside, it's really playing off the good job done by number 67, Logan Hawkins. And that's what allows him to get inside. So when you play with your eyes, you can see the emotion from Bischoff. It really makes everybody else get excited because they're like, where did he come from?
He's got to be good. He went to St. Vincent, St. Mary's High School, right?
Yeah, that's true.
Alma mater of one LeBron James.
A lot of good players have come out of that school, too.
Oh, man. They're doing Akron. Lakers did. All thanks, LeBron and AD and some other guys. Gibson on first down through traffic. He will get that to Grimes Jr.
And since you're talking about the Lakers, Rajon Rondo, that's what Zach Gibson has to be tonight.
I like that.
And really,
that's a good analogy.
It's a pretty good job by Gray on the outside. He steps up and takes on Key Thompson. And I'm telling you what, Gray is a guy we're going to continue to look at, but he kind of stepped up in pass protection that time. With a little bit of an extra rusher, and there's a look right there at Ryan Beckman, but that's a good job that time by Gibson, this entire offensive line.
First down for the Zips again. Like the poise Gibson showing this game tonight. Knight lost the football. Just like that, things change. Jared Hampton, fumble recovery for the Bobcats. And Ohio gets the ball right back on the sudden change.
The ruling on the field is fumble, recovery defense, first down Ohio, timeout on the field for media.
We always talk about running backs having to move another position. You come from wide receiver. Are you used to the contact? And this time he just goes off his leg and gives a gift to Jaron Hampton.
For Akron, big pickup.
Yeah, and here he goes. This is Grimes. He's going to come into this area, and watch what he does. He kind of settles down. And here you are on the move, and he does a really good job of finding him right there in that soft spot in the zone.
First down, Akron. About 5 minutes to go here in our first half. Zips looking for a confidence-building score as they try to break a long losing streak tonight. Deion Dollard between the tackles. Gets physical again. North-south running. Polished off by Hudson, but I love the way this guy has been powerful through that line of scrimmage.
Yeah, and I also like what the offensive line is doing. Let's take a look at Bryce Peterson inside. Look at this block, and then you get another block from number 73, Owen Murphy. These guys are blocking very well against this Ohio front.
Jeremiah Burton got wiped out there. Pass. Goal line. Flag flies. Touchdown. Nate Stewart, the captain, has the catch. And he got punished and hung onto the rock for an Akron score. Might have a targeting investigation here. Let's see. 14 yards if it stands, which I
think it will. The play is a touchdown. Personal foul targeting defense number 11. The play is under review.
That's Tariq Drake, junior from Leavittsburg, Ohio. On the touchdown delivery from Gibson to Nate Stewart, redshirt senior, Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. His first TD catch of the year.
Well, this is the same play they scored on a week ago, but this time from the outside. And in terms of the targeting, I think that probably will stand, but what a throw. You just talked about Zach Gibson being able to make some of those throws. And look at him. I mean, kind of sidearm.
That little sling.
I mean, man, he puts some zip on the ball in between the hash marks. And, again, that was a confident throw, Dave. Get this to the middle of the field.
Well, I get it to the middle of the field, take their time out to set up Smiegel there, field goal kicker, and there he is quickly on a knee, trying to center it up. Timeout call. 4 seconds.
Now here's Frank Solich, the Wiley veteran coach. He saved the two timeouts to potentially ice Smiegel here. We've seen this happen before.
We could have a double icing.
You've caught a lot of hockey in your day.
That's
so
right.
A lot of icing calls, right?
A lot of hockey back in the day, man.
You get that icing call all the time.
So Smiegel will be the man here. The Syracuse transfer did not kick at Cuse before coming to the MAC and Akron. 2 for 2 last week. He was good from 41-28 and the home loss in Akron against Western Michigan. Had a 25-yarder last year.
Now, okay, he's centering this up. This is a pretty long kick now. You're talking about not a lot of wind here tonight, though, at least not from our vantage point. But look at those flags. They're moving a little bit, a little left to right. So he's going to have to kind of measure this in terms of his target line a little to the left.
From 50, this would be a career long. Here comes the first ice. Now, do you want to let the kicker actually go through and take a practice
swing?
Yeah,
absolutely. And I think a lot of times you see that on a professional level, mm-hmm. right? The NFL kickers, if you ice them, we're snapping and we're going to get our practice kick in. Sometimes the college kickers and the snappers aren't always on the same page. But if you're Cameron Lyons, who's probably one of the smarter long snappers and short snappers in the country, you got to get that snap off. I agree with you on that, Dave.
Only points last year for Smiegel were against Ohio. He made it 7-3 in the first quarter on a 25-yarder. They lost the game 52-3. Only points scored by the Zips. So a chance here for 10 first-half points for the Zips. And scored 13 last week, losing at home to Western Michigan. So here we go from 50. Ohio has one more timeout. Let's see if we try another icing if you're Frank Solich. No icing. Kicks off the mark. Not close and no good.
And I got to get on the Cameron Lyons, the AFCA Good Works member, one of the best snappers I've seen. And I didn't think that was a good snap. And that messed up the operation just a little bit. It was a good job of getting the ball down, but it wasn't a great snap.
And sometimes you're thinking about that possible icing timeout coming. But it didn't that time. End of the first half. 14-7 our score after the break. Adam Zucker, Brian Jones, Rick Neuheisel, Randy Cross, Aaron Taylor standing by in New York with a halftime report. Powell makes a fair catch. And Akron gets the football first to begin the second half. That's a shocking stat. That really is a surprising number for an Akron team that struggled so mightily on offense a year ago with Cato Nelson, who probably will either return this year or get a sixth year with a medical redshirt shoulder injury. And Frank Solich was all business talking about Akron yesterday. This is a desperate game for each team. With a six-game regular season schedule, you know, guys like Jared Dorsey were saying this week, look, we're thinking about playing seven games. You're going to get to the MAC title game. You got to win tonight.
Yeah.
They can't lose this game in the MAC East. Deion Dollar feature back next to Gibson. As we start the second half, play fake. And the pass, Grimes Jr. has it. In front of a leaping Ben Johnson. Make that an incomplete pass.
Yeah, you like to see Gibson, you know, get that ball up. But Gibson has had a pretty good first half. Look at the decisiveness on this throw. It was really he getting it to his young guy, Grimes. And then this shot down the field. Look at the catch by George Qualls. The RPO, the quick strike inside. Not a lot he didn't do in that first half to make some believers out of Zips fans.
Nate Stewart, team captain, touchdown catch. Akron's lone score, opening 30. Dollar gets physical. Jamison Collier tried to bring him down but could not. It's a gain of about 9.5 on the run there by Teyon Dollar, who continues to get physical and just mash tacklers tonight.
And watch the offensive line. Look at Peterson down the field. Bryce Peterson making a block 10 yards down the field.
Sets up third and very short. Less than half a yard. Dollar breaks a tackle. Fourth down and then some. Gibson the block. The QB helping out his running back. It's a huge pickup for Akron, who continues to spin and fight with Justin Burchette. He's out of bounds. But what a physical run again for Teyon Dollar, who would not be denied and kept on trucking downfield.
And Gibson, we talked about his leadership, the emotional leadership. Jamison Collier, I'm in the game. I'm a quarterback that everybody follows, and Dollar follows for a huge game. Gibson, he's a guy that's really winning over, continuing to win over his teammates. And I'll tell you what, man, we got a lot out of that phone call with him. His teammates are getting a lot out of this performance tonight for both he and Dollar.
Dollar needs a breather, needs a drink. Gets him at some oxygen. It's a gain of 39. He was out of bounds at the 27.
What a journey has been for him.
Well, it sure has. Junior, Lake City, Florida, Independence, junior college transfer. He's the man now, Jeremiah Knight. Is the running back tripped up, may have tripped over his own lineman there as he tries to slide off left tackle. Kylan McCracken, 300-pound redshirt sophomore, Cleveland Heights, Ohio, has played offensively for Ohio.
And get made the dollar. I mean, also Alabama A&M.
Yeah.
He went there and he only had like 61 yards rushing, so that's why he ended up going on with the Independence. And that's, once again, like me and you've been talking about, Dave, Butler, Independence, all those schools are pretty formidable. Here's another one of these bunch sets at the top of the screen. Let's see if they throw the screen game out there at some point.
117 rushing yards for Dollar tonight. Out of the pistol. Gibson throws. That sideline route. Nate Stewart has the catch in front of Elias Motley, one of the Motley twins. Yes, there are two sets of identical twins on this Ohio team. The Lorman twins and the Motley twins. Lormans are tight ends, and the Motley's defensive backs. Lorman's not been a factor tonight.
No.
Because Ohio hasn't had the football.
They really have.
Thanks to the time of possession dominance from Akron today.
And I think right now, even though you didn't get the field goal at the end of the half, that was the thinking. You controlled the game. You've got two downs to get this first down. And again, they're bringing in their backup quarterback to run some type of wildcat.
I'm going to call it the wild zip.
The wild zip, I like that better.
My Jaden Horton. Second time we've seen him. Biggest play of the game in the second quarter on that fourth down carry. This time the spot looks good enough. He's got a first down. Move those chains. Akron does it again. My Jaden Horton. Wild zip.
Yeah. Listed as a safety.
He is listed as offensive back.
Yeah, so
and the coaches did not tell us about that yesterday because coaches, you know, don't always give away the game plan. Brian Gasser, the Akron offensive coordinator.
Can't give it all away,
did
right?
Did not mention that.
High school quarterback. Let me keep this one under my sleeve. You're not going to get it, Dave.
Those coaches made timeout call. That's interesting. Early timeout, second half. Always
Whoa.
Something to keep in mind for Akron. As they drive here, again controlling the clock in a one-score game. This is an Akron program that hasn't won in a long time. Well, 2018.
Well, I think that
big play off the timeout. Mark that one down. Early second half. Gibson throws. Overthrown this time for Scipio. With Elias Motley, the corner for Ohio on coverage.
I thought Scipio had an opportunity a little bit in last year's game against Ohio to make some big plays, and they gave him another shot there.
Gibson 11-19, 139 passing yards tonight in the touchdown, and no picks, taking care of the ball. Had a pick six last week in that loss at home to Western Michigan. On second down, Dollard runs it to Troller. Out of green jerseys. Out of Matthews. No gain this time for Teon Dollard, who was galloped tonight for 117 on 13 carries.
And where's Will Evans, number 9 for Ohio? He's the guy that we talked extensively with Ron Collins. 7.5 tackles for loss a year ago, number 9 on their defense. This is a passing down, and you would expect either Conrad or Evans to be able to beat these tackles. So here we go again. This is what they're doing, these stack sets to defeat the man coverage they saw a year ago.
Big throw down try, long drive again for Akron. Gibson dancing away from tacklers and finally put down. Who is it?
Will Evans.
Will Evans and Austin Conrad got there right on cue. You said in our Zoom call with the coaches yesterday, Will Evans has got to be more relentless getting to the quarterback, and that time did make a big play.
And watch both of them come off the edge. Now, he gets inside easily of Murphy, and he makes the quarterback step up. Now, on the other side, there's nobody. But Conrad makes his way around, and those were the things we were talking about. So now the pressure is back on Smeagol to come through, and he didn't at the end of the first half.
From 34, missed from 50 to end the first half. Big kick for Akron here. He's got it. We have got a football game at Pete Steam in Athens tonight, thanks to Akron. Winless a year ago. Winless since 2018. Forget about those numbers. Playing well tonight.
Rick Weiner told us that, and when you think about it, that just goes to show who's dominating the line of scrimmage. And Akron and this young offensive line, Teon Dollard, what a game.
Fitchin the kickoff. Lefty, directional, try to keep it away from Tuggle, which is a good move. Ben Johnson on the return.
Or is it?
Maybe it's not a good move. Tuggle brought one back 93 last week in this loss to Central. There's a flag down at the end of the Johnson return.
Might have been a face mask, and it could have even been a horse collar, some late activity. One of those, it seemed like they got a little high on that tackle, Dave, near the out-of-bounds marker. Well, here it goes. I think it's Fitchin. He does grab the face mask.
He sure does.
You see it?
Kicker. So sometimes those directional plays really back. This is going to be a plus 15, right?
Yeah, and Fitchin is a pretty aggressive tackler. The first kickoff they had a year ago against Ohio, he comes down the first play and wham! I'm like, what? I kept rewinding the film. And now he says wham again, except this time he breaks the rules.
Redshirt senior, Orange, California. 12 games a year ago, as Chafe talked about, primarily kickoff man for Akron. 26-yard return for Ben Johnson, the upback, who's a reserve Sam or strong side linebacker. He's gotten quite a few snaps tonight with Jeremiah Wood.
There are two
hurt.
Fouls on the play. During the return, face mask, kicking team number 13. After the play, personal foul, late hit, receiving team number 47. Those 15-yard penalties cancel. First down, Ohio.
So it's Austin Conrad, star offensive player, who was whistled there.
And they've got some numbers wrong. It's Jerry Fitchin.
Fitchin's the 47.
Yeah, Fitchin, right. Fitchin gets up talking noise after a face mask. Now, that's a first. You get a lot of firsts from kickers, but not after you face mask getting up talking some noise.
There was another hit, I think, from Ohio. You couldn't quite see to the right there off our shot there from our great crew here at Athens. So hence the two personal fouls.
I'm still tripping over pitching. I'm sorry.
So we're wondering who the quarterback would be, and it is Curtis Rourke. And on Armani Rogers to begin the second half here for Ohio. Play fake to Tuggle. So Rourke, some pressure, down he goes. He is sacked. What a huge play for Julian Richardson. The junior from Albany, Georgia, gets the QB and makes him pay.
Oh, watch him right here. He's going to go right around Nick Sink, their left tackle. And you see him right here. He's engaged, and then he used the snatch and pull to get over the top. And what a rush that time by him. Nick Sink struggled a little bit, I thought, a week ago. And it's not a surprise that he was a guy that got attacked a little bit from Central Michigan. Richardson takes advantage early here in the third.
What a spirited game tonight from Akron. All three phases. He's trying to break the losing streak. Arslanian is hurtling blockers. Hooks deep, ball broken up. And incomplete on the goal route to Ogbonna. On coverage there for Akron, key PBU.
Ogbonna gave up the slant last week to Dwayne Eskridge, and this time it's a drop, but he has.
Defense number 6, 10-yard penalty, automatic first down.
That's the boundary corner, Jordan Riley, who on the other side of the field is whistled and flagged for the hold.
Wow.
Wow, that's right.
Because Ogbonna had done at least a decent job against Hooks on that play. And these receivers got after the Akron corners a little bit a year ago. Jordan Riley, the guy with the holding call, I thought he played well against Ohio last year, but.
Automatic first down. That's huge. Tuggle. He's laying it. Hold on. For dear life with Nizier Sy. We mentioned the defensive front for Akron banged up. Lots of issues, and they're shorthanded. We were watching them warm up. They had 6 total guys.
Right.
For the 3 positions pregame, that's not what you want in terms of personnel.
Well, I think that's the reason why you've seen Akron control the ball on the other end with the run game, to keep this defense off the field. They've stayed relatively fresh. It's been a very good game plan by Tom Marth and this Akron staff.
Second and 4.
Defense fresh.
Tuggle again. Makes a nice move, bounces outside. Demontre Tuggle thinking about a stiff arm. And instead it's pushed out of bounds by A.J. Watts, the free safety. Also played some nickel. Really good leader, coaches tell us. Coordinator Matt Feeney high on him. It's gain of 8 and a chain mover for Ohio.
Yeah, he says he kind of mirrors his game as a Jalen Ramsey type nickel. And that time he saw Mitchell, Tuggle get around Mitchell to the outside. That range from the 6'2", 192-pound, 190-pound Watts.
Look at those numbers. 14-8 first downs for Akron.
Yeah.
I mean, wow. Script has been flipped so far. And a great football game tonight from Athens. On first down, Tuggle navigates, spins away. Bischoff got to him. And made the play defensively for the Zips.
Sly as well. He got underneath.
He's played well tonight.
Yeah, he has. And I was interested to see how he would handle this increased role. You see him wearing a number 11. That always means that you feel like you're a big man with some quick feet.
Second out. Finally, a Lorman sighting. Ryan Lorman, one of the Lorman identical twins who played with Joe Burrow, Athens High School, right here in Southeast Ohio. They didn't win a state championship. State runner-up, 2014. Joe went to Ohio State out of Athens High. Then, of course, LSU, and the rest is history, en route to being the top pick overall by the Bengals.
It's third down and 10. Will you get the pressure from Matt Feeney, or does he play some zone here? Pressure has worked tonight for the Zips.
Here they come again. Mars landing up the middle, along with Bischoff. Pass, Isaiah Cox, who makes the catch in traffic. Bob Arslanian is going from side to side of the field on a blitz from his inside linebacker spot, and then retracing and pursuing Cox to make the tackle.
You couldn't have broken that down any better, Dave. And I think that the thing that makes that even more, if he doesn't make the tackle, it's a touchdown, because they had all the blockers set up. And now we're getting to see a kicker who Vandenberg's confidence, let's see. I watched him in pregame warm-ups. It was okay. This is a challenge for him. Had some struggles a week ago.
From 44. Perfect. He's got it. Tristan Vandenberg, sophomore from Buffalo. By Zoom this week, young fan enjoying the game here tonight. He was a big baby, about 1 year old. He was a bubble. he was a big guy. Sometimes babies are a little chubby, you know, they eat a lot. Healthy, right? He's healthy. It's all good. Boogie Knight from his three ventures out. Not a lot of room. And he dropped shot on the 20 at the 18.
And speaking of babies, I got an opportunity on our Zoom call to spend some time with your latest baby edition, Nirvana and
Malachi. Yeah, those guys
Malachi
are awesome.
Incredible.
I appreciate that. That was his first Zoom call.
I think it's incredible that the fact that you added two to the family. And he looks like a little me when I was a baby, actually. I mean, you're just a special person with some of the. Your family just keeps getting bigger and bigger.
We really enjoy being foster parents. That's a lot of fun with those guys. It's a blast.
So Jasper and Royce today.
That's right. FaceTime. Got the crew. Let's see how Zach Gibson from suburban Atlanta responds here. Deion Dollard makes a tackler missed on that all night and trucks ahead and goes north again. Here's that note we were talking about on Dollard. First Akron 100-yard rusher since Warren Ball ran for 112 against Troy. Get this, September 23rd, 2017. Been that long for the Zips. That's an impressive stat.
And Ball was a transfer from a bigger school. I believe it was Ohio State. In a big fastback, 4.4 speed. Same type of guy you're getting with Dollard here. We talked about Alabama A&M and the Independence Community College. But physically, he matches up in the MAC.
Well, he sure does. Big game tonight. Picked up two there, second and eight. Gibson, think about tossing a dollar instead. Pressure from Dorsa. So eventually catches up with Zach Gibson.
And that was a smart play. You don't want to have any negative plays at this point because you really control the time of possession. And you're putting you in a favorable position here, third down and six. What did they go to? I think they've got to really work at some point here, the middle of the field. He's comfortable throwing those routes. And I expect them to potentially go there on this play.
Look at that time of possession stat, as you mentioned. Wow, that's shocking. So it makes college football so great. A lot of things you're just not expecting. Gibson the pump fake, throws over the middle, has his man. Big catch, big play. George Qualls just keeps on trucking and dragging tacklers and pushing them like Jamison Collier. For even more real estate, first down Akron.
Well, you get a lot of these spacing routes, so you'll have somebody come in motion and go there. And that spacing route, so it makes the defense space out. That's what the zone coverage does. You see everybody space out, and that's where Qualls sits down at. So that's a perfect example of what Tom Arth brings to the table. Former quarterback at John Carroll and two-time All-American, and he's really has an offensive innovator.
Long-time pro career, NFL, AFL. Overseas. Key Thompson to stop that time as they just keep on feeding the man, giving the rock to Teyon Dollard.
And I know you like that spacing. I know you like that spacing route. Because think about it. You space everybody out in zone coverage, and something comes open because everybody really doesn't have the keys right away. They're not going straight to the quarterback. So it's actually a pretty good concept against a team that's mixing in some zone tonight in Ohio.
Light in the box, right?
Yeah, no doubt.
Spread them out. It's worked very well tonight, to say the least, for Akron. Second down. Dollard again. Stays busy again. Justin Burchett had that knockdown tackle. Gain of two. There is an injured Bobcat. Yeah, Burks is hurt.
Yeah. Might be Bryce.
Zach Burks. Yeah. Redshirt senior from Kansas. Had a tackle last week in that road loss in Mount Pleasant to Central Michigan. Ohio trainers attending to Zach Burks now.
See, and here's the last play with Zach Burks, and you see us going against Owen Murphy, and it was not him. It was actually number 52, Bryce Dugan, who runs in. The guy that we circled runs into Zach Burks, and you see his knee get rolled up. That was a tough injury, but you still got a third down here. They went to the middle of the field the last time, Dave. Maybe this time they go back to Qualls at the top of the screen.
There you go, Akron, head ahead of Ohio. 2 for 13 on third downs. 6 converted here tonight. And you saw a big disparity between Ohio's third down conversions. Deion Dollard on the screen pass, trying to drag tacklers toward the marker. He does get into plus territory to the 49. He's shy, though. Now Tom Morris. Three to go, third quarter. On fourth and manageable. What do you think here, Jay?
I think he's going to make the decision to go for it, I would think.
Oh, going
to
punt.
Yeah, I would have possibly thought about going for
me
it.
Me too.
Right, because I think you've got enough going in the run game to keep them off balance. And if you got a fake in at this point, maybe that's something that you think about. I think you've had control of this football game.
Kyle Romanek punting to Cox. Isaiah Cox makes the grab. The fair catch indicator came a little late there.
Let's go back to that, though, about you're thinking about what to get into it when we come back.
It'll be the first topic of conversation, Corey. Don't worry about it. One score game. Isaiah Cox hoping to make some explosive plays. To you by Sonic as we break down these quarterbacks. Zach Gibson has been very impressive for Akron.
Well, so is Curtis Rourke. He just hadn't had as many opportunities simply because of the fact that the Akron Zips have controlled time of possession and they're still down by seven. And we'll get into a little bit more about why this drive is so important for Ohio.
Curtis Rourke stays in a QB. Play fake to Tugger. On first down, the redshirt freshman fires. Hooks has the catch in traffic. Oslanian, the help there from Jalen Kelly Powell to make the play. The Michigan transfer as Hooks has the catch.
This one of the popular route concepts. This is a dig route or a deep square in. He separates. Not bad job that time from Ogbonna, but it was still a decent route by Hooks and a better throw by Rourke.
Gain of 22. Curtis Rourke taking over for brother Nathan, hoping for a shot at the CFL, which is idle for now due to COVID. Nathan had an incredible career here. 111 total touchdowns. Even caught two touchdown passes. Now it's Curtis's turn. Cam Odom, flag flies. Jordan Riley, boundary corner. On coverage, will get whistled either for the PI or defensive holding. Let's find out which one.
Pass interference, defense number 6, 15-yard penalty from the previous spot, automatic first down.
Move the chains here for Ohio. Let's go back after we see this replay. I want to talk more about that last drive. Do you agree with the call?
Yeah, I do, and I think it was unnecessary. Now, he got a step on him, and Odom does that at times with his speed, but you got to trust your technique if you're Riley.
So that first down for the Bobcats. Akron electing to punt the last drive on fourth and short. Flea flicker play back to Rourke. Everybody's covered, so he throws it away. Odom was close to it, so was Jordan Riley. So Tom Arth, fourth and three,
right,
in a tight game, end of the third quarter, elects the punt. You didn't like it? I didn't like the call.
Well, here's the thing. He talked to us all week. Just get to the fourth quarter. He's thinking about getting to the fourth quarter. Here's my thing. They score on this drive, you're down two scores. I think you've already just about gotten to the fourth quarter at that point with 2:23 left in the third. So I believe that staying aggressive in that situation would have been more advantageous, I think, for the tone of the game at that point.
Interesting. But second out here. Flea flicker trick play covered well. Tuggle between the tackles. Dragging tacklers again. Julian Richardson got there but got towed a few yards.
And that's the other reason why you would have gone for it. You have to remember what me and you started the broadcast talking about. There's Matt Feeney. He knows he's short-handed defensively. He's called an outstanding game, by the way. But that defensive line is going to wear down at some point.
Movement up front would have probably cost the Bobcats 5 off the 10-yard run from Tuggle a moment ago.
Well, that helps.
False start. Offense number 70. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Senior Fishers, Indiana, Nick Sink.
We talked about him a little bit as well.
Mm-hmm.
And there's Sink on the edge. And he's getting ready to go against an active player tonight, Ryan McClain. You've called his name a lot. But again, that defensive line is stretched a little bit, right, Dave? That's what we talked about at the beginning. So going for that fourth down even earlier would have given them potentially even more rest for this stretch run.
I had 11 penalties last week. Loss on the road at Central. Something that Frank Solich emphasized with us being so important in week two. Six-game schedule, regular season. Curtis Rohr runs. Stopped again by Ryan McClain, who's been active. So I'm kind of a nerd, you know, when it comes to these interviews. We had some time today, night game. I went back to last year's interview with Nathan Rourke. I had it on my phone.
Right.
And listened back to it. And he said, well, Curtis is going to be a better passer
right.
than I ever will be. I'm a better runner. Would you agree when you compare the brothers?
I don't think there's a comparison between the arm strength of the two. And I think that Nathan had a pretty good arm. Curtis has NFL-type arm strength, and he'll get stronger. Footwork needs to speed up for the younger Rourke.
Here he is right now. Here's the arm strength. Looks for Hooks on the deep ball, who adjusts and can't make the play. Chu Ogbonna on coverage step for step with Shane Hollywood Hooks of Ohio.
And right now, Ogbonna is starting to get into a rhythm. Now, it's a little bit of hand fighting. You got to be careful. That ball's slightly uncatchable.
It was a pretty physical confrontation downfield. But I'm okay with that.
You like offense.
I like defense. I know you do.
A little bit of hand fighting down the field.
It's a physical game. Third down. Big play here. Akron's defense trying to get off the field. Rourke passes into coverage. It's overthrown and incomplete. Riley on coverage there. Try to hook up with Cox.
Look at A.J. Watts. I mean, he's really doing a good job. Now you're going to see Watts coming to your screen late. Good protection out there by Maservi. We wanted to see him, but there's Watts breaking on the ball. And also the guy you mentioned earlier, Riley. But look at where Watts is coming from, the inside out. They're like, Cox, we got it figured out. And so we were wrong. Arthur gamble on the fourth down, not going for it. A non-gamble pays off.
Last moments of the quarter. Jeremiah Knight in traffic indicates for makes a fair catch, and Akron gets it back to begin the fourth in a one-score game. Not what the football experts and me thought would happen. What a game here tonight from Peden Stadium. Exciting fourth quarters on the way.
Summer, and now's the time to see if they can break this streak and how much they've grown.
Been a long time since they've won. October 27, 2018 against Central Michigan. 18 in a row. Doris has some pressure. Gibson reads it perfectly. Makes a nice throw to Nate Stewart. And a good pickup on first down for Akron.
And they're working Nate Stewart inside in the slot. Now that's been an adjustment as well. Last week, they worked him a lot on the outside numbers. Now he's always worked in the slot. Sometimes they'll motion to get him in the slot, but tonight they've just lined him up in the slot on occasion. And they've worked actually George Qualls on the outside over here.
He's your gotcha.
I think he's gonna have to show up at some point here in the fourth.
Long cadence. Dollar hit by Motley first. Xavier Motley, one of the Motley twins. You know, it's interesting, Chavin. Speaking with Tom Arth, the first thing that comes up about trying to rebuild was the culture. It's a very widely used term in college football. He talked about grades. Now, the team GPA was disastrous when he got there. D's and F's. Now they're A's and B's. 3-1 team GPA last semester. Best it's been in years at that.
No doubt. And I mean, listen, let's face it. They've been big in the community, too. You're talking about some of the stuff they've done with the regional food banks in the Akron-Canton community. The football team themselves have won awards for their community effort.
It's impressive. First down. Here's Gibson. Going to run with it this time. Redshirt freshman from Georgia. Slides down. Keith Thompson late made a big hit on Sean Name. Keith Thompson's a physical guy.
Yeah, he is. And I tell you what, man.
Whoa.
Yeah, you get out of his way. I mean, we saw him last year on a kickoff. I think it was against, the kickoff was against Central Michigan.
It was.
He actually almost took somebody completely out. And he's been physical on special teams. He's grown into this new role from last year when he ended as a starter.
Akron trying to take a big step tonight. Intercepted. The big pick for Ohio. Jetty Lab. The sudden change, and Ohio's in business on the biggest mistake of the night for Zach Gibson. 15-yard return for the redshirt freshman from Cleveland St. Ignatius High School, Jetty Lamb.
Well, here it goes. There's a mistake made by Qualls. Apparently, he's supposed to go out. He goes in on the option route. You saw him talking to Qualls after the play. That miscommunication between Qualls and we said he'd have an impact, but maybe not that impact was expected. A negative impact. That interception may not have been on Gibson.
Now, short field, Ohio. The redshirt freshman from Oakville, Ontario, just outside Toronto. Curtis Rourke, Nathan's younger brother, taking over the reins here. On first down, Buckner behind him. And it's incomplete with Jalen Kelly Powell, the Michigan transfer on coverage.
That's a positive. I mean, he had to step into a full-time role this week with Corey Thomas not being available. And they like his athleticism. I think, you know, went to Cass Tech High School in Michigan. And, you know, they like the way he moves. Probably doesn't react quite as well as Derenijo to the run, but they want him to kind of put it all together here as the season moves on.
Two receivers to the left of Rourke here. Tuggle. Feature back. Two freshman QBs going head-to-head tonight. Demontre Tuggle makes a cut. And it does go north to the 15-yard line. A.J. Watts. Physical defensively there for Akron. Well, so third down, big play.
Yeah, no doubt. And let's think about this, Dave. Do they blitz right here? You've got these stacked looks. A lot of times you get out routes out of these looks.
Here's third down. Here's Rourke throws. Sideline route. Hooks has got it. He's marked at the 11. And he needs the 9 for the first down.
And that's a long fourth and two. And if you've got an extra man in the blocks, really, in terms of Lorman. But look at Tuggle. He's upset that they're going to bring out the field goal unit. But that puts him up by 10. You can understand Frank Solich's thinking at this point.
Tristan Vanderburg, sophomore from Buffalo. This from 45. Last week against Central, he made the kick, then there was a timeout call. Didn't count. This from 28 to put the Bobcats up 10. He missed it, wide right. He pushed that kick, and we're still in a one-score game here tonight at Peden Stadium.
Well, he missed one from that same hash mark a week ago. And the extra point was wide right, right? So when you don't execute the fundamentals in terms of special teams, there's always a negative plays for some reason. And then
resuming action. Tyler, physical again. Hampton can't bring him down. No one can bring him down. What a run for Teon Dollard again for Akron. Give yourself a first down, young man. You deserve it. 19 hard-earned yards.
Yeah, very good play call that time by Brian Gasser, Tom Arth. You spread them out to run. You'll see it inside, the block inside. And the move again that time against Key Thompson. Thompson has struggled to get Dollard on the ground, and now they've got Dollard lined up out here in the slot. So they're moving him around a little bit.
146 rushing yards tonight for Dollard on first down. Here comes some pressure off the edge. Zach Gibson. Throws on the run, just beyond the reach of Nate Stewart, who laid out and gave his all for Akron. It's incomplete.
Yeah, but this is an improvisational type of throw, and this is a good play, I think, by Zach Gibson, and it's an excellent effort by Nate Stewart. Now, you can't quite get to it. On third downs here in the second half, you can see the body language by Gibson. He's like, just missed it. But on third downs tonight, they've been really good, 50%, which is a significant improvement from 2019. They talked about having improved as a football team. We've seen every bit of it here tonight.
Well, no doubt about that. Knight, the carry. Jeremiah Knight, former slot wide receiver, Ohio State transfer, rambles out to about the 44. So big third down here, Chase.
And I think the last miscommunication that we saw between Qualls and Gibson, one of the reasons you had that miscommunication was because Qualls was inside. JC transferred. You've been doing Zoom meetings all spring and summer, and now you're in the slot in the fourth quarter. So they move him back outside now, and I wouldn't be surprised and maybe think about Dollard here in some shape, form, or fashion. They've actually got Booby Knight in the game as well.
Play clock runs down here. Gibson gets a playoff just in time. Avoids the delay of game. Running for his life, trying to throw on the move. Intercepted again. Key Thompson with a pick for Ohio. And the big return for the Bobcats. Still on his feet before he's pushed out of bounds deep in zip territory. Big play for Thompson and the Bobcat defense.
The coaches talked about him not trying to do too much. This happened a couple of times last week when he gets under the pressure. By the way, by Will Evans, a guy we talked about, rolling to his left. He tried this three times last week. One interception was dropped in the end zone on a play just like this. These jump passes across his body. He knew he had to eliminate them. The coaches knew he needed to eliminate them. He has not tonight.
Got the belt. He's got the belt, Chief. I love that. You get a silver helmet for the offensive play. And the defensive turnover belt.
He should share it with Gibson for that throw.
Sure. Oh, Sean Allison. Now number zero this year, carries. And slides off left tackle for about four on that run.
And that's debilitating for this Akron coaching staff because that's what they've been talking about all week. And Zach Gibson, you can see his expression on his face. He knows it, but he just couldn't. His competitiveness just would not allow him to not try to make a play. And that's where you have to balance it as a quarterback.
First career pick there, you're right, for Keith Thompson. Ohio couldn't cash in last time off the pick from Jet Elad on the missed field goal from Vandenberg from 28 yards out. Here's second down. O'Shawn Allison runs into trouble right away with Ryan McClain. He's been everywhere tonight for Akron's defense. And the wrestling type drag down, throw to the mat, tackle for Akron.
Again, another junior college guy. Yeah. Garden City, another one of the top junior colleges. 5 sacks, 10 tackles for loss there a year ago. He's from Albuquerque, New Mexico. One of the things I liked about him, besides just effort, he's long. And when we talked to the coaches, they said his length, it provides something different for this Zips defense. He's shown some mobility here tonight.
All right, third down. Interesting.
Well, let's watch him. Here he goes right here. There he goes. Let's see if he can make a play here on third down, rushing the quarterback.
Kicking game from Shaky. Ohio wants to cash in. Rourke, flush right, the redshirt freshman. Throws on the move, end zone, risky pass, broken up and incomplete, looking for hooks there. Jalen Kelly Powell was there for the breakup, and who was on the pressure?
Yeah, McClain.
Ryan McClain, just like you said.
Well, I mean, we gave him the spotlight and to see what he would do, and he showed up.
He came through, didn't he?
He did. Rourke came through too, but he gets the quarterback hit and nearly causes the interception that you called, Dave.
What do you do here now? After the missed field goal a moment ago by Vandenberg, you said he struggled. Gonna give another shot?
I think this shot is more about the rest of the season, and they're going to give it to him.
Right.
And again, it's interesting because he struggled on some of the shorter stuff, the extra points. We just saw him miss a short field goal. This in the middle of the field. Let's see if he handles it.
From 29, no. He missed another one. He pushed it right again. No good wide right from 28. No good wide right from 29, and it's still a one-score game. Not one, but two interceptions. First, Elam had the pick, then Key Thompson, but they can't cash in, Shave. Special teams, again, a factor. Wow. Missed wide. 17 every time.
We all have a job to do. Do your responsibility. Unfortunately, he missed. We may need you again. There's 8 minutes left in the game.
First and 10, again for Akron. Trying to break that incredibly long losing streak. Play fake, Gibson on first down, not close. Rhymes into the intended receiver. Gibson picked last two possessions and in his own end, Jay, but it didn't do damage to the scoreboard.
Well, you say that, and I think it did some damage to his psyche.
Now, that was a miscommunication with Qualls. But this next one, this is the mistake he nearly made last week, throwing across his body. That's the disappointing interception of the two.
Good pressure, Will Evans. Finally being relentless.
Yes, he is.
Turnovers, it's all Akron, and that's that. But what's most important? Scoreboard, one score game. Three receivers to his right. Gibson throws to his left and set. Qualls has the catch. Motley on coverage for Ohio.
And my question is, how does Motley match up on the outside lanes? And we'll take a look at this offensive line. You wonder why you haven't heard Evans, who got his hands up. It's because of Gray on the outside. But Qualls' size at 6'2", presenting a problem for these corners on those throws.
Big third down, third and one. Zip 6 of 13. Ohio is 1-for-9 on third down conversions tonight, but still has a one-score lead.
I'm going to run the ball right here, and I'm going to do it to my left side. So I would run it over here to this left side is where I would run this football.
It's Dollar. He's hit right away. Jet Elad got there in the backfield. Actually a loss of a yard. And now on fourth and short, from your own territory, once Tom Arth got mine, he is going to punt the football away.
Well, you got two timeouts left, so you got to be thinking now, under 7 minutes, how do you manage those timeouts? Because, again, if they get any points here on this drive, then you're going to be having to save those two timeouts after you score, if you can get a score.
Dominic, shift a little bit to his right, grab the snap. Punts to Isaiah Cox, grabs it at its 30. Puts a foot in the ground, tries to go north, and so at the 30. Great story. Good kick coverage there from Akron. Very good.
Absolutely. Julian Richardson, he's been a factor on their special teams for 2 years now.
42-yard punt. Kyle Romanek. Redshirt freshman punter. Cox wanted more, didn't get it. Still being postponed right here on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Busy action tonight and tomorrow. Three games tonight, three games tomorrow. Now the quarterback is Curtis Rourke. You thought you wanted to see Amani Rodgers there.
Absolutely. We'll get into it after this play.
But it's the redshirt freshman and not the transfer from UNLV. Tuggle, first down. Big play, DeMontre Tuggle. Dragging tacklers close to midfield. Gets out to the 47. As Lanyon finally makes the play. Gain of 17 for Ohio.
Watch this double team right here. Actually, it's a one-on-one block by Kurt Daneker, and he opens it up. And his addition back into the lineup has been welcome for them. He's opened up a lot of holes tonight.
J.J. Watts helped clean him up as well. He's showing pressure off the edge on first down. Tuggle caught by Watts on cue along with Bubba. So why would you want to go with Armani there instead of Curtis Rourke?
I think the run game has been different with him in the lineup this year. So when he's come in, their run game has exploded, I think, at times because of his factor as the extra runner. That's not that Rourke can't run. It's that Rodgers adds an extra dimension. And right now, you want to run the ball and make them use their timeouts.
Big night for Tuggle, ran for 79 last week. Road loss at Central Michigan. Arslanian shows pressure again. Look out, DeMontre Tuggle. 100 yards and then some. Big pickup. Finally wrapped up by Jordan Riley. Not before he chews up big time real estate for the Bobcats. It's a first down for Ohio.
Well, you're going to see them get logged here on the outside. They're going to come out here and they're going to log these guys coming up inside. And so here he goes. He goes inside number 24, Darinijo, and that's what allows him to bounce it outside. So you got to be able to keep contained in these types of rush situations when you're bringing an extra hat and nobody's in contain on that last play.
Gain of 25. Tuggle up to 115 rushing yards. So 200-yard backs tonight between Dollard and Tuggle. DeMontre trying to add to the total and Will. Arslanian, Bischoff, more tackles. The bubble last year, top 10 in the nation in tackles per game. More than 10 tackles and outings for a 5'9", maybe, linebacker in the back quite a player. 4 yards there for Tuggle.
I like that neck roll he has.
It's like old school.
Yeah,
I love that
man.
That he's fun to talk to.
Tremendous player.
Family owns a carpet business, the third generation. That could be something he takes over one day soon. Tuggle trying to take over this game. Gets physical. Again, the play by Jordan Riley. The corner for Akron.
Now you use the timeout, baby. Yeah. Or did they?
The clock is stopped here. 3:55. Now it's
reset.
Rolling.
Actually, they gave him the first down. It's a good thing that they did not use their timeout, if you're the Zips, because it was a first down. And so that changes everything here. At this point, you almost want them to go ahead and score to lengthen the game, because at 17-10, they keep running it down. You're going to have to use these timeouts at some point.
First down. Tuggle adds to the total and drags tacklers again. He is a physical runner.
Yeah.
John Mitchell made that play defensively. Macken was concerned. He was going to be a health scratch tonight, but added to the travel roster very late.
And you see Tom Marth on the sideline. He's imploring his defense, come on, I don't want to use this timeout. You got to stop him. I want to just save myself this timeout and put this field goal kicker back on the field. The same field goal kicker that you said you wouldn't allow to kick it on the field goal. So
I wouldn't personally.
But time is working off. This is a little bit of a gamble here because you're shortening the game by not using that timeout.
Ohio used a lot of clock. Tuggle again. His landing was the first to get to him, but he leaps, tacklers, and gets close to the 5-yard line. And then Jalen Kelly polished him off. Vandenberg waits. Clock rolls, Chief.
Yeah, rolls, and again, a pretty good block up front by Cottrell, and he also had a decent job up there. And there's finally the timeout.
Charge timeout, Akron. They're second of the half.
Here's
this
my thing.
This will also be a media timeout.
Great at Matt Feeney, their defensive coordinator. You see Bubba Arslaney in right there, the eyes. So all of these guys are going to have to go. You're going to have to bring everybody. You're going to have to leave your corners in man-to-man. You're going to have to bring everybody a run blitz on this down.
Biggest play of the game for Akron. Desperate for a stop. Desperate to break the losing streak of 18 straight. Rourke, hand to Tuggle. Bounces outside. Tuggle lunging. Didn't get to the end zone, but did get to the marker. Gain of 4.
Yeah, well, they just played it straight up. And Darinizio made a very good tackle, but
Tutu is hurt here.
You're going to see him lined up right here. And when this run bounces outside, he's going to be the guy that has to make the tackle right there. He has to make it in the backfield. But he allows that hidden yardage, and he gets hurt on the play. But he was in position to make the play as the fourth player. Maybe if you just bring him on a pressure like we talked about, he would have made that play in the backfield.
Sophomore, 2-2, Darinizio. He's shaking up out of Fort Lauderdale. We told you his story. In fact, the Akron coaches just love what they heard from the St. Thomas Aquinas head coach down in South Florida about the academics and the ability. Took him sight unseen. Played well tonight and being looked at by trainers.
I just want to say something to not only Darinizio, but this Akron defense. This is one of the better performances I've seen in terms of limited personnel in some aspects, in terms of depth. And you got to give Matt Feeney credit. This was an offense that last year was sixth in the nation in third down percentage. They've been one out, I believe. That was one of their few third downs they picked up all night. This defense has mixed around. They've tackled well. That was their first third down attempt. They were 0-8 for a while after converting the first third down. So Matt Feeney and this Akron defense, they've had they played a very good game.
Totally agree. Called a great game tonight. But first and goal here for Ohio, trying to cash in. Tuggle behind Curtis Rourke, latest Air Canada here in Athens, Ohio. It's Tuggle, navigates, pushes forward. End zone, touchdown, Ohio. Second rushing touchdown of the night for Demontre Tuggle, trying to put this one away for the Bobcats.
A Well, you kind of wanted that to happen, though, right? Because you don't have any timeouts left.
New kicker for the PAT here, Trey. Noah Fortkamp will come in after
the ruling on the field on the previous play is touchdown. The play is under review.
All right, let's take a look. Make sure that DeMontre Tuggle was in. Huge game, of course, last week. We told you about the TD run and the kickoff return for a score.
Yeah, look at Mitchell and Hawkins fighting inside. They fought all night.
It's called touchdown on the field. So we need video evidence to show us that the ball didn't break the plane. Football. Let's take a look here. Goal line. Tough to see the bodies there. What do you think?
Well, I think he had already crossed at that point where we paused it. He had already crossed earlier. There he goes. You can
broken
see
the plane,
right there. And I'll circle it when he gets to the – let it run a little bit more. Right here, you can see the ball has crossed the plane of the end zone. All it has to do is cross this front part.
Right,
and
just
does that.
Break the plane, that's
yep.
all.
So it was a touchdown. Good call by the line judge right here. And they've done a really good job, I think, calling this game tonight.
9 plays, 70-yard drive, all from Tuggle. The entire drive. And the cash-in score on the first
after goal. Reviewing the play, the ruling on the field of touchdown stands as called.
22 carries, 139 yards, 2 scores for Tuggle. He's come through tonight, the senior from Channel View, Texas. And the JUCO transfer from Kilgore College. I haven't seen a lot of O'Shawn Allison because Tuggle's played so well tonight.
And he was a good player last year. And I wanted to make sure I give Calvin Diggs and Tim O'Day, the referee, and Calvin Diggs, who made that call, some credit for their performance tonight, along with the rest of this officiating crew.
I love that silver helmet, buddy. We're going to sign it. We salute. Take a pick. It's pretty cool. PAT is barely through. From Noah Fortkamp on some issues with the snap and hold.
So what's been your favorite sideline? Is it still the turnover chain? Is it something else? Is it?
I like all those celebrations.
I like Cincinnati.
I know Akron has a big pencil. We're hoping to see the pencil tonight. We assign it with a 3-foot pencil.
I like to sign my stuff with the pen. But no, I like Cincinnati with the dunks. Have you seen Cincinnati the way they with the turnover they slam dunk on
they
the
slam
sideline?
Dunk? Yeah, they do that. Yeah. And then on the offense they pound the drum. That's a good one.
Right.
What a year for UC at the American Conference. Wow.
And I think they're a team that to me, top to bottom, because now Desmond Ridder is playing well. You have to kind of factor them in a little differently than you did when he was struggling earlier in the season, but I think he's played a lot better as of late. He's truly a dual threat. His confidence has gone up. Give Mike Denbrock and that staff credit for adjusting their offense to fit his game.
Career rushing touchdowns 13 and 14 for DeMontre Tuggle for his legendary head coach Frank Solich. Looking for win number 114, getting closer and closer. Don Peden's all-time Ohio record of 121. Jeremiah Nate from the team. On the return for Akron. Looks for room, looks for a lane. That is nailed at about the 26.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of Drew Plitt and Caleb Huntley. Their tandem in the backfield there. They're one of good players at Ball State. Justin Hall had a big game last week. So Ball State's a team you want to check out.
Dollar caught pretty fast. Not much doing there. Austin Conrad, team captain. You know, Austin, we listened to a pretty cool Zoom call and a podcast that showed all the captains, including Austin Conrad, being so instrumental in the MAC resuming college football this year. The restart, November, December. Pressure coming off the edge. Down he goes. Jeremiah Burton gets the Gibson. And the sack and the late going.
You got a sack dance down and nothing else, right? You got to like that sack dance. And finally, they got over the top of number 73, Owen Murphy, who's played pretty well tonight. I think him and also Xavier Gray on the other side have battled. But you keep working, and this is the time where you're eating if you're a defender. And I've been surprised a little bit with their inside interior offensive line. Now, we expected Bryce Peterson to play well, but Jordan Daniels has played pretty well, that right guard spot as well.
McCrory the tackle, pick up 22. Gibson over the middle. Has his man again, Nate Stewart, with a catch and then the big run as well. kept on motoring. Jamison Collier finally made the play there for Ohio. In the final moments of the fourth, one timeout for Akron. Trying to score fast, then get the onside kick. Gibson, here comes some pressure. Flush right by McCrory. That throws on the move.
Receivers out of Lutheran West. He had 100 and catches and 20 touchdowns in high school from Ohio. That's a positive sign, getting some other receivers involved, and they've done that tonight. That's been another positive for Akron.
First two group catches for Name have come tonight. Here's second down. Here comes some pressure again. Conrad is all over Gibson. And polished off in the end by Key Thompson. Wow. Wild-looking play here in the final moments.
Well, Key Thompson plays a
timeout, Akron.
60-minute game.
Timeout, Akron. Their final timeout of the game.
Key Thompson is a thumper and also an interceptor. We've seen a little bit of everything tonight from number 38 in green.
Yeah, well, Conrad leaves the sack on the field, and Thompson says, well, if you don't want it, I'll take it. We had 5.5 tackles for losses a year ago, and we talked about his special teams work, but he's kind of developing now. Boogie and Dollard, we thought they would be the key. 187 rushing yards. They're throwing a party in Akron. They can't believe it. 2 out of 10 on third downs for these defensive gambles. We talked about Matt Feeney. They checked every box, Dave, on their side. Create a light box. Ohio did that. 5.6 yards per carry. Speed up Akron's offensive line in terms of maybe make them deal with your stunts and line games. I don't know. I think Akron had poise all night. The mistakes were unforced errors. And we've got a lot of history in terms of tennis. Zach Gibson has served up some unforced errors at times.
I like
tonight.
The tennis analogy. That's good. 165 yards from Dollar, by the way, of that total we saw a moment ago with Boogie Knight. Catch for Grimes Jr. in the late going here off Akron's last timeout. 5 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter. Tony Grimes, true freshman out of Pittsburgh, Penn Hills High School, has really played well. It's a gain of 10. Could be the last play of this hard fought, what appears to be a victory for Ohio. But Frank Solich told us this was going to be tough, and he was right.
Well, the thing about this Akron team to watch out for in the MAC, every one of these offensive linemen, they're young and they're freshmen, this does not count as a year of eligibility. So
on the board, and that is that. 24-10 the final. Losses.
I don't mind
Akron.
That, by the way.
Okay.
I had a couple times where I got into some stuff.